almost wanted to wipe my hands with my sandwich. Not a good idea. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, my first impression on the Makeup Obsession Black is the New Black palette, which has butter on it, because my sandwich was on top. Not a good idea. But anyway, here's the palette. In case you don't know what she looks like, oh, it's a cardboard packaging, and let me try to bend it back real careful. They are all magnetic. At least the cardboard palettes from Makeup Obsession are all magnetic. And here is the color story. Which is really pretty. It does remind me a lot though of the Blackout Reloaded palette that I have here. But you get a few more shades here versus that one. I already did a first impression with this palette. I will link it underneath the cards. But today is this day. What I'm going to do is I'm going to swatch on a clean bare arm. And I already kind of have a little bit of an idea of what I want to do. I do have to make sure that it is not too similar as my first impression with the Blackout palette. So let's see. Let's see. So let me first get some makeup wipe and then I'm going to swatch. I think that's better. I'm going to start here and then go like that. Yuki. So here is the color story swatched. Wow. These two are so foiled. Then this one is a little bit more, it's not really a satin because it's still a shimmer but not as intensely foiled. And this one is a duochrome. But yeah, even the light gray and the white show up, which I'm very impressed by. Let me think. I thought I had an idea. My idea was to go with the light gray. However, I think I'm going to go with the color deep, which is this more reddy shade first. I'm going to start with the color called deep. I'm going to press it on my eye with a slightly bigger brush. I haven't set my eyeshadow base. And it's the Smashbox in light. I'm just going to kind of use this as a first transition shade. I'm just tapping it on my eye. Oh, it was a very big brush. I'm moving to a slightly smaller brush. Still the same color though. This was actually the brush that I was looking for. And I just thought, I don't remember it being that big. That's what she said. But I actually had a wrong brush. It does not matter though. But this is a color that you can nicely build up. It is not overly pigmented. You know, in your face pigmented. That also has to do with the brushes I use though. Just so you know. I also want this underneath my eye, but for that I'm kind of using more of the side of the brush. And a very pretty color. Okay, let's deepen it up a tiny bit. Let's get the color Smoked, which is this one, which is basically the middle gray. Color-wise in the palette. I'm going to deepen up the outer corner. My eyes are not really hooded, well, a tiny bit just because of age, but mostly they are deep set. And what I want is I want to be able to see that gray when I look forward. So I'm kind of looking forward and relaxing my brow. And then I'm just going to lightly sketch where I want it. Then when I look down a little bit, I can see here a little bit of a darker line. So I know I need to follow that to make sure that it, you know, shows up when I look forward. Same happens when you have a hooded eye. You kind of sketch out a new part, you know? So basically just ignore the moving part and just sketch where you want your lid to end. Only if you have a hooded eye, your skin does this, you know, it hangs over. And because I have a deep set eye, I have space extra. I hope that makes sense. Otherwise, go check out Angie from 4F Beauty, because every video she explains the difference between a hooded and a deep set eye. And if you know which one you have, you can kind of adjust your technique. And you can follow along with almost any eye makeup tutorial. They blend very, very nicely on top of each other. It's not really patchy either, so that's good. Now I'm going back to a big fluffy brush. I'm just going to kind of sweep over everything. Yeah, I'm grabbing a little bit of the color Deep, the first color that I used. And just... I also want that color smoked underneath my eye, but concentrated on the lower lashes, so quite high. This shade is a bit powdery in the pan though, just so you know. Cute, okay. Shimmer time, but which one do I want? But that's also a shimmery shade, isn't it? Okay, so let's get the... you know, let's get this one, the color Shadow, which is a duochrome shade. Let's get that one, because I don't know why. It looks pretty. I'm going to grab it with a flat brush and then I'm going to spray. A lot of the time I use a glitter primer underneath shimmers, but not when I do a first impression. Oh, that's pretty. And because it goes on top of that kind of reddy brownie base, that shows through, but I think that if you put this on top of the black base, you get, you know, you can play with it. Oh, it's so pretty. I'm going to fade it here at the ending. Ah, yeah, and I can see if I put it on top of that gray, the green shows up more as well. So very, very pretty. Oh, I forgot to test it dry. Oh, well. Okay, let me think about eye pencil. I have here a copper colored eye pencil from L'Oreal. It's in the color Super Cooper. I'm going to put that in my waterline to kind of tie that color together with, you know. It's early. It's always early when I film, so I don't know why I keep saying it, but it's always early. I'm also pulling it down just a tiny bit. And what I'm going to do then, I'm going to grab the shimmer I just used. I'm going to smudge it over a little. I think that's cute. Okay. Inner corner highlights. Let's get shaded to kind of keep it in the same color range family. Let's get shaded this color to put in my inner corner. Cute. This is dry. I think dry is actually pretty, pretty nice. There's the eye look so far, guys. I'm going to put on a liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. What I'm doing now is I made whale tails that were not really the idea, so I'm trying to make it kind of less harsh and a little bit more part of the eye look. So I'm actually taking the black from the palette and placing it a little bit on top, but a little bit in as well. So I'm kind of filling it in. And then pulling the black shade on my lid, so that it flows a little bit nicer. And a tiny bit in the inner corner or outer corner of my lower lid. Let's get just a fluffy blending brush. Just flick it over and in. I'm going to flick it in. That's basically what I want to say. Just to make sure it's nice. And of course I have fallout. Of course I do. No, I don't. Now I'm going to put on some mascara. And I have here the Catrice Glam & Doll False Lash Mascara in Waterproof. It's new. It's nice. Oh, I forgot the tagline. Of course I did. God damn it. Let me do that real quick. Does not really matter which one you get. It's just a black eye pencil. So here is the look just before the falsies. I'm very glad that I added the black in. Okay, I'm going to put on my falsies now, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to give you, first off, show you the end result and to give you my first impression and thoughts on the Makeup Obsession Black is the New Black palette. Falsies and lippy are on, and here is the finished look. I opted for my more dramatic falsies today, the style Milan from Soso. And I'm actually very, very glad that I did, because I really like that more dramatic look today. For lipstick is a combination between a lip pencil from Catrice. It's the lip foundation pencil in the color Cool Brown, which is pretty dark. And then I use my NYX Butter Gloss in Cookie Butter. And then kind of tapped a little bit so it flowed nicely, you know. I don't really know if this was what I was going for, but I do really like it. So there's that. So yeah, let me give you my... Oh, by the way, I think I forgot to mention that. The rest of my makeup will be listed down in my description box. So let me give you my thoughts on the Black is the New Black palette. First off, it feels really, really luxurious. It feels really sturdy. The whole aesthetic of it, I really, really like this. It just feels high-end, guys. I don't know. The weight is good. It's nice. The mirror is very, very nice. It's a very nice, sturdy mirror. And the mattes feel really nice and creamy. They feel silky, but they are not overly so that you blend them away on your eye. I hope that makes sense. I use them on a tacky base. And all these shades are a little bit on the cooler spectrum, even this one. And I was a little bit afraid maybe that it would get patchy. It didn't. This is such a nice formula. I need to get more of these palettes, because the formula in this palette, and I already knew that with my Dream with a Vision palette, the formula there is so good. I don't know how they do it for this money, because they feel high-end to me. So yeah, it's a very, very, very good quality. So if you like this color story, you could also obviously get the Reloaded palette, but as I said in my first impression of the Blackout, the Reloaded Blackout palette, that palette is more for it's still good, it's a good quality. It's nowhere near as good as this quality though, let's just be clear on that. But it is a good quality, at least in my opinion it is. The shades were easy to work with, and they were not... You could be a little bit more heavy-handed with them. Does that make sense? And sometimes that is nice. I remember back in the day when I did my makeup, I was not really proficient with makeup. The only time I wore makeup at all was when I went out and then out to a bar, you know, like that. I would have had a lot of fun with that Blackout palette, because the formula there is very easy to control. And yeah, it's just, you know, for €5, it is also not breaking the bank, if that makes any sense. You get a lot of shades. This one though, it feels so luxurious. When I feel these shades, they feel so nice. They feel like my Ace Booty formula. The difference between Ace Booty formula and this one is that Ace Booty is very, very pigmented. And some people are scared of that pigmentation, therefore are not trying the Ace Booty. But the formula is really, really good. This is the same kind of soft feeling. It's very easy to work with, but it is not a scary pigmentation. You dip your brush in and you kind of need to make sure you almost have nothing on your brush before you put them on your eye. Does that make any sense? This palette does not have that. The black, you saw me use the black with a small detail brush. It was a stiffer brush. I do have some blacks that kind of stick more, like for instance the black with the sparkle in the Reloaded palette has a very sticky formula. So if you need to use a black to pack on, that one is perfect. This is a nice blend out black, if that makes any sense. So yeah, I like the color story, well obviously, otherwise I wouldn't have bought it. If you are on the fence between this one and the Lime Crime one, I just think you need to save your money and get this one. Because again, the formula is amazing. I have never tried Lime Crime, but the formula is amazing. You get more shades. And you know, for the price of the Lime Crime, you could get these both. And then have more shades. And that really pop of red that is in the Lime Crime palette is in the Intoxicated with Love. So yeah guys, it's a good palette. It's a very good quality and I cannot wait to play with it more. And I also cannot wait to combine it with the Intoxicated with Love. Let me quickly show you the color story. So here is the Intoxicated with Love. So it's a little bit more warmer than this one. But the reds that are in here, I cannot wait to play with this one either. You know, especially combining them and they feel so luxurious. I'm very, very happy that I got this palette and I hope that they do more of this style, you know? It's amazing. I'm not saying that you need it, but if you want a color story like this, you don't want to pay a lot of money, at least in my opinion, but you want a very good quality, get this palette. If you want a color story, but your budget is very tiny, or you just don't want to spend a lot of money on eyeshadow regardless, get the Reloaded one, because that one is also good, but not as good as this one. If I had to choose between the two, yeah, I would pick this one. I would. There are very gorgeous shades in this one. For instance, this dark gray shimmer is gorgeous, and I don't have that here. But still, formula-wise, yeah, this beats that one. Yeah, it does. And I knew it would. So it was not a big surprise, actually. I think that's it, guys. I think I'm starting to ramble. And I don't know. It is just a good palette. If you are on the fence about this palette, don't be. If you love the Juvia's Place formula, you will love this one as well. So yeah, guys, that was it. This was my first impression and a look with the Black is the New Black palette. Let me know down below how you like it, if you want it, if you have it, and all that goodness. Let's chat about it in the comment section. For now, I'm going to sign off. Going to wish you a fantastic day. Oh, before I forget, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. It will help me tremendously. It will let YouTube know that it needs to share me with more people, you know? So yeah. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye guys.